Hi everyone, good evening. Can you hear me, everyone?
We are able to hear.
Yeah, good evening, Jitendra. We can hear you.
Okay, great. Guys, please turn off your mic, and if you have any queries, you can type on chat window. Okay, good. So, what we did in our previous session, I think. You guys know very well. We did, I think, routing in our previous session. We already did our day one, day two, and day three. And today the session is day four. And today I'm going to discuss about. We already discussed static route from a WAN interface and a DNS reachability. We did, I think, in last class, and how to create an object, how to create a tag. Right, and today we are going to discuss about NAT. Right, anyone? NAT. Can anyone help me? What is NAT?
NAT is nothing but network address translation.
It is a full form, dear.
Yes,
what is NAT exactly?
Yeah, it is used to for address into IP address, IP address into name.
No.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, no problem.
Communication between the LAN network and the public
network. It is used to map public IP to private IP.
Okay. I'm getting a message from Redmi. I don't know who is. Please, guys, use your name, okay? It's a at Redmi, it's a 040. It's not a name. So use your name always once you join our session. Okay, so someone say that private address to public address.
Yeah.
Okay, correct. So
you save the private IP address, and for the security purpose, and you know the private IP is not routable.
Okay, good.
In a
good.
Cloud, so we do the NATing because okay. It's not because the internet don't know about the private IP.
Okay, good. Okay, you know, guys, most of the students are saying that it's used.
It's partially correct. It's partially correct that it can do vice versa as well. You can convert public IP to private IP as well.
Super.
So convert public to private in a static routing.
I think we
do dynamic routing.
Okay.
We do the private to.
Okay. Guys. Okay, please turn off your mic. That's good. Okay. You guys are Rajnikant. Please turn off your mic. Now we are let's discuss. Okay. Okay. Now, so the topic. Sudhir, please turn off your mic, dear. Okay. Now, so NAT is what it is used to translate one IP to another IP. Remember always. Okay. Whether it is a private to public to private or public to public. Okay. NAT is used to translate one IP to another IP. Okay. And we know NAT from CCNA routing and switching. We have a three type of NAT, right? Static NAT. We have a dynamic NAT, and we have a PAT. Okay, most of the students will say this answer, sir. We have a three type of NAT: static NAT, dynamic NAT, and PAT. Right? In a static NAT, you will say, sir, it is used for mapping 1-to-1. In dynamic map, in dynamic NAT, we will create a pull off IP address, and we will allow our LAN users to go to outside and select a one IP from this pull. This is called a dynamic NAT. And the last part is what we can translate multiple private IP addresses in a single with a single public IP. That's it, right? That is the answer. I think you guys you want to say, but you know, if someone asks you what is exactly NAT, what kind of NAT you have or type of NAT. So remember always, we have actually two type of NAT. Okay, the first is what? Source NAT. And second is what? Destination NAT always, okay? Source NAT and destination NAT. Okay, in source and destination, we have static, dynamic, PAT, okay? So actually we have two type of NAT. Source NAT and destination NAT, okay? If we are using source NAT, so source NAT is translating, then it called, if a source IP is going to translate, then it's called source NAT. And if destination IP is going to translate, then it is called destination LAN. Let's clear with a scenario. Okay, see, I have a topology. Wait, for NAT, please turn off your mic, everyone. Now, for source NAT, okay, we have this scenario. Okay, this is my source IP. Okay, this PC trying to access, you know, google.com. okay, and it's trying to generate a traffic for HTTPS. Now this is the source IP. The source IP is going to hit on this interface. Okay, now he's taking a randomly port number, is called a source port number, and then destination IP is trying to go this IP address. Now this is the destination port number. Now when the traffic will go on to this gateway, then it will change. It will change this IP address and change with this IP address which you assign statically. That is called source, and it will change the IP address with this IP address. Now this IP will go to google.com and, you know, translate this, and when the return traffic will come, he will reply. This will reply to this public IP, then it will go to the LAN. Okay, and that is called source net. We are only translating only source. Destination net, destination IP is not going to translate, right? We are only translating only our what? Source IP. Understood this scenario, everyone? We are not going to translate google.com IP address, right? Everyone, please type yes on chat window if you understand anything. Here we are only translating our source IP. We are not going to translate google.com IP. Okay, clear? Now see, what is exactly destination NAT? See, if I'm working in a scenario, see, I have a Palo Alto device. Okay, I have a Palo Alto device which is connected with my ISP internet, and I have my LAN, you can say my inside network, my trusted network. I have a DMZ network. With DMZ network, I have connected multiple servers, and these servers I will allow for my outside users. So this is called DMZ. Okay, so now what is destination NAT? See, if someone trying to hit on this here I have a IP address, public IP, no problem. But for destination NAT, I will purchase another public IP, and I will translate. See, I have a public IP 10.1.12.1. okay, now I am going to purchase another public IP 10.1.12.50, and I'm going to map this IP address with this server. This is my web server in my organization, and here I'm using 192.168.10.50. okay, now I'm going to translate what? If someone trying to hit to this IP with port number is what? 443, then I will translate this traffic to this web server, and that is called destination NAT. Understood, everyone?
Yes.
What I'm changing? I'm not changing my source IP. What I'm changing? My destination IP. Clear, everyone? If you are facing problem with basic concept of NAT, then please go through with CCNA routing switching videos. Okay, guys, clear what is exactly source NAT and destination NAT, and you know, advantage of NAT is what? We can save our IP addresses. If I am working with thousands of computers in my LAN, thousands of computer in LAN, so I do not require a public IP for my each and every computer. Okay, so I can translate 1000 IP address, I can translate 100 IP address with my single public IP. So that is the advantage of NAT. We can save off our IP addresses. And the second thing is what? I'm going to type here. The first we have what? It's solve, or you can say it's a save of IP addresses. The second thing, advantage, security. Yes, security is the second advantage. Okay, I'm not going to display my private IP address to publicly. Okay, this person is only trying. There is an outside user, and he's trying to only going to hit this public IP. you don't know exactly what IP address is going to associate with this. Okay, if he will try with this IP only. And then this is my responsibility. I'm going to configure on Palo Alto device. If someone trying to hack with this IP address with this port number, this is 443, then I will redirect the traffic with my web server. Okay, so this is called security. I just hide my web server IP address from public. Understood, everyone? Is that clear?
Yes,
that's good. Please, if you just on chat window fast.
Yes,
clear. Everyone, could you please turn off your mic, dear? Good. Now, let's do configuration. You know, we have this topology. If you go with our Palo Alto day 1, day 2, and day 3, okay. In day 3, what we did basic routing, static routing, default routing. So if you understand the routing now, we are going to discuss our NAT configuration in our same topology. So I have a Ethernet 1/2. Understood, please, the scenario. This is connected with my Wi-Fi network, okay? And this Ethernet 1/1 is connected with my LAN network. I have my one LAN computer. And this PC is exactly used to configure my Palo Alto device. This is connected with my management interface. So this is our topology. Now, let's start our configuration. So I have a Palo Alto device. And I can show you what is IP address. Admin. Password admin. Show interface management. And on management interface, you can see as I have one default IP address. So I'm trying to access this Palo Alto device from my management PC. So where is my management PC? Yes, here I have. And I'm trying to open my Google Chrome. https://192.168.1.5. And guys, one more information I want to share with you. After this session, I'm going to create a video how to deploy, how to create our own lab setup for Palo Alto. Okay. I think lots of students are facing this problem. Okay. So that's why, after this,
Jitendra, and also please help us, how can we get the license for those Palo Alto PA?
For license, you need to purchase, okay?
Okay,
without license, you cannot do lots of practical, like content ID, URL filtering, okay? Wildfire, you cannot do so for.
But like whatever, if we will be downloading that particular Palo Alto device from the website, are they not providing us with the like initial license
trial license?
In that trial license, I'm not able to work on this content
ID. Yes, you cannot perform a lots of content ID or antivirus malware protection or spyware. Okay. Yeah, or you can say vulnerability protection. You cannot perform. You require a license. Okay. So for basic configuration, you can do, no problem. Lots of things you can do. Okay. Now, for NAT configuration, let me check our scenario first. So we have interfaces. Remember, guys, we already configured the interfaces, and now we are going to create. See, for NAT configuration, we need to go on policy, okay? On policy, and click on this NAT. And see, I have a NAT configuration here. I'm going to delete this configuration. In previous session, we didn't configure NAT, right? Right? Did we complete NAT configuration? No? Okay, good. Okay, no problem. See, so now for NAT configuration, click on here, NAT, and you can click on add. See, then you will get an option. See, I have this tab, NAT policy rule, and now I have a journal tab here. I need to configure a name for this NAT rule. So I'm going to configure LAN to WAN. That's the name. Now I can use tag if you want, but I didn't configure tag, no problem. Now original packet. So the original packet is what? Source Joe. So please turn off your mic. Shoaib. Okay, now so this is your LAN zone. Okay, so source zone is what? It's LAN zone. Destination zone is what? Your WAN zone. And destination interface. So you can see in your topology, your destination zone is what? Ethernet 1/2. So I'm going to use this interface Ethernet. Click here, Ethernet 1/2. And I'm going to allow any services. Okay. Now, if you want to specify any specific IP address from your source address, okay. If you want to allow, you know, specific users, are you in, this is your LAN and you have multiple computers. So if you want to allow a specific group of computers to translate, so you need to create an object and you can specify here, you need to create an object. Okay. You can click on add. If you don't have object, so you can click an address. So you can create an object, which IP address you want to allow for translation. Here right now I'm going to use any source IP address and he can go any destination IP address. Okay. Now translated packet. If you click here, translation type. So if you click here, so you will get this option. You will get first option is what? Dynamic IP and port. Dynamic IP and port. That is called what? It's a PAT. Okay. Then we have dynamic IP and pull. Remember, dynamic IP and static IP is what? Static NAT. So here I'm going to use what? Dynamic IP and port. Going to select. Now translated address or interface address. So I'm going to use interface address. Now interface, I have Ethernet 1/2 and click on OK. And then commit. Okay. Once you commit this, so if you want to verify through CLI after NAT configuration, so you have some command to verify your NAT configuration. Okay. So this is wait. This is your first command to check, or you can say verify your translation verification. The first command show running NAT policy. You can verify your source IP, your translation method, which method you are using. And if you want to, if you're using a dynamic IP NAT, so you, if you have global IP, you want to verify. So this is a command show running global IP pool. So there are some commands you can go through with CLI. You can verify here.
If we want to specify any particular specific NAT, so in that case, like ASA, we can include and all. So in this Palo Alto, how we can do it? Like if you want to specify
Particular LAN you want to verify, to allow, right?
I'm saying that if there are like more than 5 or 6 NAT we have created, NAT would we have created. Okay. So how will be from CLI access, how will identify, how will set the log for a particular, check the log for a particular route?
Logs?
Yeah.
For log verification, you have monitor page. You don't, no need to go on CLI box, okay?
Okay.
You have a tab, okay, for monitoring. Okay.
Okay.
Now we are actually doing configuration. Okay.
Sure.
So this is the dynamic IP and port configuration. And now, do you think after NAT configuration the traffic will go from inside, or you can say from LAN to WAN? Do you think the traffic after this configuration, your IP will go onto this interface and translate and go to internet? Do you think?
No. We have to create a static NAT.
No, we configured dynamic NAT. It's a good, but you know, after NAT configuration, we need to add
the rule also.
Perfect.
Security policy.
Yes, yeah. because our Palo Alto device is called, it's called zone-based firewall. Okay.
Zone-based, yeah, right.
Please guys tell me what is exactly the zone-based firewall. What is a zone-based firewall technique? Please type on chat window. Don't turn on your mic. Type on chat window. Take your time, no problem. What is zone-based firewall? If you don't know, so you are in wrong batch. What is zone-based firewall?
Zone base is like we can create from LAN to MPLS, LAN to MPLS to LAN. We can create as a zone base.
Okay. Okay. If I'm using Cisco ASA box, Cisco ASA, okay. Cisco okay. Firewall. So, this firewall is it work with JBF concept?
Is no.
It concept?
Security level.
Perfect, no. Perfect. It's work with security level, not zone-based firewall technique. You know, correct. You know, in zone-based firewall, remember always, if someone is saying you, you know, I have a great firewall and it's working with zone-based firewall technique. So understand always, in zone-based firewall, you need to create zone. You need to specify your interface in their respective zone and you need to create security policy to allow LAN to WAN, WAN to LAN, WAN to DMZ, okay, LAN to DMZ, everything you will configure here, okay, that is called zone based firewall. The traffic will allow, you can allow, okay, but on Cisco ASA firewall we have a concept of what? Security level. On Cisco ASA firewall, if we have a see, if I'm working with Cisco ASA firewall, so we have inside network, we have outside network. If you configure inside here, I already told you about ASA. See, if I'm going to type inside on this interface, it will get automatically security 100. Level of 100. And if I'm going to type here anything, not inside, anything like let's take example outside, so it will get a security level of 0. Cisco ASA firewall always work with security level concept. And what is security level concept? Traffic will always flow from higher security level to lower security level, always by default, no need to do anything, okay, by default. And only traffic will allow TCP and UDP traffic. But this is the concept of Cisco ASA. But you know, rest any firewall, if you're working with Fortinet, if you're working with Checkpoint firewall, if you're working with Palo Alto firewall, okay, so these firewalls are zone based firewall. You need to configure or you need to tell firewall, okay, I'm going to allow traffic from inside to outside or outside to inside or outside to DMZ. Everything you will configure. Understood, everyone?
Yes.
Please type yes on chat window first. And please, guys, respond. Please respond, everyone. Please. Okay. Now, turn off your mic, everyone. Now, I need to create a security policy to allow. Now, if you click here on security tab in policy, we have a security rule concept. Now, you can see we have a two rule. By default, we have two rules. The first rule is called, I can use a magnifier here. So guys, you can see we have what? Interzone default configuration, and we have what? Intrazone. We have two rule already here. And now you can see what is exactly. See what is intrazone default and what is interzone default. So if I have a Palo Alto device, okay, and I'm creating, I have a 6 interfaces, okay, I'm creating LAN zone, I'm creating WAN zone, and I'm creating DMZ, okay, these two interfaces I'm going to put into LAN zone, okay, these two interfaces I'm going to put into LAN zone. This interface I'm going to put into DMZ, and these three interfaces I'm going to put into WAN zone. So if LAN user, if this user trying to communicate with this server, so he's part of same zone, so he can communicate with each other. Okay, there is no rule required. Okay, by default it's allow. I will show you by default it's allow. But you know, if you want inter-zone communication, what is inter-zone? If LAN zone wants to communicate DMZ, if LAN zone wants to communicate WAN, if someone trying to if someone coming from WAN interface and trying to go to DMZ, I need to create a policy, because by default inter-zone communication is denied. By default inter-zone communication, I can show you. See,
Sir, sorry for interrupting here.
Okay, no problem.
Like from WAN interface, from outside, they want to connect the DMZ zone. Is it possible? I think it's not possible to connect the from WAN to DMZ zone, right?
You are saying I have a Palo Alto device and I have an internet connectivity, okay? And I have a DMZ. Mm-hmm. You are saying I cannot create a connection from outside to DMZ, right?
Yes.
We can, dear. Understood the
yeah problem. we can but
we required some... if I'm not going to allow users from outside, so how can I allow my web server, SMTP, DNS, FTP servers?
Yes, right sir.
Okay, please turn off your mic. Okay, now that first I'm going to discuss about intra-zone communication. See, for intra-zone communication, you can see, guys, zone any, address any, user any. I'm not going to discuss right now HIP profile. Don't discuss it. This is the source IP. Okay, now destination, zone any, address any, application any. By default, you can see. It's allow. And you can also see another rule we have. It's created by default. Inter-zone communication from any zone, okay, for any zones and from any destination zone, any application, any address, you can see by default it's there is a rule, it's called deny. Clear, everyone? That is a default rule. Understood?
I'm sorry to interrupt, sir. Okay. So in the intra zone, that means you have got multiple LAN zones. We are allowing the traffic in between.
Yes, you know, we have a LAN zone. See, I have a Palo Alto device and I have three interfaces. And these three interfaces I'm going to put into my LAN zone. Okay. So there is no requirement for rule. Okay. By default, you have rule. See, you have a rule, right? Intra zone communication. So if traffic is coming from LAN zone and trying to go to another LAN zone, same LAN zone, so by default traffic is what? Permit, okay? But if these LAN users, they want to go your WAN zone, okay, or different zone, so you need to create a policy, because by default different zone cannot communicate by default, okay?
Jitendra, we have to allow the access from LAN to WAN zone. Suppose that in my request, suppose one LAN user wants to talk with the WAN's any web server.
Yes.
So
we can configure. I will tell you. When I will create security policy, I will tell you. No problem. Yes. This is our topic exactly right now. Understood? First, the concept for different zone, we need to create policy. Clear?
Okay, clear.
Web cluster. Yes, you can ask, dear. Web cluster. Any question? Okay, sorry. Sabrina, any question? Please turn off your mic, everyone. Now, clear, everyone? Any doubt? So let's create a policy here. Okay. Perfect. Now I'm going to click here. See, before NAT, we have security policy. I'm going to click on add, and you have a security policy rule. This is exactly firewall, Palo Alto device. If you understand this, everything is clear. If you understand this. So now we have a tab. We have a tab, general tab. We are going to give a name for this rule. And here I'm using allow LAN to WAN. Okay. And what is the rule type? So this is called what? Inter-zone communication. Now, source, click here. If you want to specify source zone, so source of the traffic is coming from LAN zone. And here I'm going to take what source from source zone, I'm going to take any IP address. But if I want to specify single user, I want to allow single user to go outside. Yes, you need to create an object. You can click here. Okay, and you need to create an address object. I'm going to allow a LAN user. You can say any name, 200 210, or you can say 25. And actually here is the IP address I'm using, 200 200 200 is 25/24, and I'm going to click OK. So what is exactly from LAN zone, what I define only this, I'm creating all policy for this user, 200 200 250 25. See, if I have a user here, I have a switch, I have a user here, and what is the IP address? 200 200 225. So I can specify a single user to go outside. Okay, for single user I want to create a separate policy. For group of users, if I have a group of computers, I'm going to create these group of computers. I'm going to create a policy for these group of computers. Yes, I can. If I want to allow complete network, yes, I can, no problem. So here I'm just giving you example. If you want to allow single user, if you want to create a policy for a single user, so you can. But right now I'm going to allow everyone from LAN. Okay, user, we didn't configure user right now, so I'm not going to discuss here. What is destination? What is destination here? So destination is what I'm going to add. It's called WAN zone. Okay,
WAN zone.
Okay, now from WAN destination is any, right? I'm going to take application, any application, service URL. I'm not going to choose anything. Action is important. So in action you have option what, allow, or you have option of drop,
deny.
You can say deny. So I'm going to check allow, and I'm going to click here checkbox log at session start. So if any user from LAN, okay, trying to, you know, start session, so log at session start, and I'm going to click OK. This is my policy, first policy, and I'm going to click on commit. Guys, any queries? Perfect.
Sir,
please type yes on chat window, everyone.
Hello.
Yes, any question?
So can we make this policy for particular destination IP also?
But yes, perfect. We can create. Yes, if you want to create a policy, yes, click add. Okay, I'm creating a rule, a LAN user. Okay, source. Yes, you can. And wait. Before this, your rule. First, I'm going to verify this IP. Okay. Then I will allow a single user. Okay. Okay. Clear. First, I'm going to verify this traffic. Okay, after that, I will discuss your task. If you want to allow single user, yes, I can. But right now, you can verify here. I just allow anyone from the LAN. So IP config, and you have 200 200 210, this IP address. Now, if I'm trying to open google.com, see, I'm trying google.com, let's see. Perfect, internet is working on this PC. And now facebook.com, wait, facebook.com, I understand there's a problem. Wait,
I think we have to mention the app ID.
No problem. Okay, I think actually I configured something about this, but no problem. It's a Google is working, right? Clear? You have a internet connectivity, everyone?
Yes.
Clear? Please type yes on chat window very fast, because I'm going to work for single user. So right now you can see he can access internet and What is IP address of this PC? IP config, you can verify. The IP address of this PC is what? 200.200.210. Perfect. Okay. Cool. Now, here in my policy, I'm going to change. Something. With source IP, I'm going to specify, not any. I'm going to specify. I already created an object. Remember, LAN user, 25.200.200.225. I'm going to allow only this particular source IP from my LAN zone. So I'm going to click OK and commit. Now, let's go on this. Click here, close, try to open, wait. Guys, wait, user ID. Okay, good. Guys, wait 2 minutes. Actually, I did other batch lab here, so that's why I'm facing problem. Now, Captive Portal practical is working. That's why we are facing problem. Now, it's good. Now, I just allow what? 200.200.225. So, only from LAN user, only 200.200.225 will allow to access internet. Now, let's try again. Now, so I'm trying to open google.com, google.com. Wait. I'm going to restart this PC first. Actually, I changed something. I just changed what the IP address. So I'm going to restart this PC and you can verify here our security from our security policy. We have a rule for from LAN user, we have a rule for only particular IP. Source is what? 200.200.225. Okay. And you can verify here from your object and address. So you have a object 200.200.225/24. Okay, he's trying to access and he can access. Wait. LAN user 200.200.225. IP config 200.200.210. I'm going to change IP address. Wait. What is IP address on LAN zone? Show interface Ethernet 1/1. Okay. So one here. Indian is 192.168.0.1 and 8.8.8.8. You can verify here what is the IP address right now. 15 So I am trying. Google.com. He can access, no. Only 225 user can access. I think there is a problem. Maybe I configured something.
So is there any option to check by which rule it's allowing?
Sorry?
Can you please capture the live logs?
Actually, in checkpoint, we have option to check by which rule this particular traffic is allowing. So is there any option here so we can check?
Yes, we can verify. Wait. We can verify from here. Monitor and session browser. Okay. We can verify the complete traffic, what traffic is going through. Okay. The IP address is okay. What? You can verify from here.
Which rule is allowing this traffic?
Right now, see, this one I'm using. This is the detail chart and this is flowchart 1 and flowchart 2. Okay. That this is the client to server communication. This PC is trying to access 200, 200, 215. This is the public IP. This is the global IP, Google IP address, and the flowchart is for return traffic. Okay. And now the protocol is allowed with 6. Okay, it's a TCP traffic 443. Now, actually, the problem with I need to allow only specific user. So I did LAN users. It's a good. The policy is good. The what is the problem? It's allow. Okay. Destination is WAN zone. Yes, it's good. Now application. LAN 200, 200, 225.
Could you please check the net policy? Their hit counts.
NAT is working. That's why you are accessing internet. Okay. NAT is working properly. No problem. Actually, I'm verifying right now. I have what is IP address 200, 225. Okay. And I just allow only right now. I have a single policy, right? I have a single policy and I just allowed 200, 200, 225 only this user to access internet, right?
Can you please try it in incognito mode?
Oh, you can access right now. No problem. I'm going to open in the Internet Explorer. Maybe it's a problem with cache. That's why. I'm trying with. Maybe the problem with cache. That's why. So I'm going to clear the cache. Browsing history. That is right. I don't know what is exactly the problem, but this is the rule exactly, guys. Okay, it will work fine.
Deny any rule in the bottom. Or
yes, if you want to deny, so I can verify here. Deny and click OK. Commit. Deny. Maybe deny rule will come, so I can show you the rule is working fine. Okay, wait. And from LAN zone, wait. From LAN zone, I'm going to use anyone. Wait.
Is there any place where we can see that
wait. First, I'm going to just display this. What is the output? Okay, wait. 2 minutes. From LAN zone, I'm going to allow anyone. Okay, and what is exactly from LAN anyone? What is the action is deny. Okay, so no one can go to access internet. Now let's verify what I'm saying. My policy is working fine. Sometime it's phase problem because, you know, maybe the cache problem. That's why we are accessing. But, you know, now I just use deny permission.
We need to, which rule is allowing this from LAN to internet? We have not checked, right?
Yes. We can check from the session browser.
Just you go to logs and just show us which rule is allowing traffic from .15 to internet.
Can I allow the traffic right now first?
Yeah, you can.
No can problem. Can I show? After that, I will discuss everything. No problem. Okay. Right now, I'm just creating a denial rule, and I want to verify right now here. Is it working or not? Please wait. Okay. So now you can see here, denial rule is working fine. Right, everyone? Denial rule is working fine. I'm not going to reboot the firewall, okay, Raghvendra. It will take time. So actually, I want to show you, is it working or not, okay? My policy is working. Sometimes it's face problem because of cache. Okay, Raghvendra?
Can I ask something?
Yes. Wait. 2 minutes. Actually, I want to display the output of. So now guys, you can see here. I cannot access the policy. I cannot access the internet access. And now you can see our policy. See, you can verify here our session browser. And this one is trying to access internet. And this is the flow chart. This is trying to access. The traffic is coming to your gateway now. Is going to outside, but the traffic is what? Discarded. Okay. You cannot access. This is exactly a flow chart. You can say a state table, or you can say session table. The traffic is going to hit your interface, ingress interface, and trying to go out egress interface, and traffic is denied. You can verify from here.
Hi Jitender. Okay. It's going by that intra zone default rule, like.
Yes. Actually, see, we have a policy. Yes. We have a policy, what a first rule. Okay, so what exactly we created a source, anyone from LAN zone destination to go to WAN zone, and what action I just take? Deny. So no one can go outside. Okay, what we did in our previous lab, okay, we are trying to allow only 200 200 200 200 225, right? But right now the policy would not work. Policy was not working fine. So that's why we just changed something. We just deny the traffic and trying to verify policy is working fine or not. Okay. Maybe the problem with cache, that's why you are accessing. But you know, I can show you, if you deny the rule, if you use deny, so you can what? You can deny the traffic exactly right now. The policy is working fine. Okay. Clear, everyone?
Yes.
Yes.
Understood what I'm exactly trying to say. This is exactly called a policy. Now I can create. How do we allow? Yes, we can discuss. How do we allow only? Yes, we can discuss 200, 225. You know, sometime you face problem. Okay. You know, so I'm not going to. I'm not going to restart.
We have a global policy for any deny traffic, right?
Yes. But right now,
so right now you added a rule in a local policy here.
Yes.
So can you show us in a logs which rule is blocking this traffic?
Yes, I will show you.
It's a global rule or local rule?
Yes.
Because global rule is having a higher priority.
See, this is actually, there is no global rule. There is a default rule here. You have a rule number 2, sequence number 2 and 3. Once you create a rule, security policy rule, it will go top to the, okay, top. So you created this rule. So he's trying to verify your first rule. Okay. If there is no match for in first rule, then he will go for second rule and third rule. Okay. Right now we created a rule and he's going on to the top.
Sir, okay. Is there any place where I can get see the hit? I can.
Yes. Wait. I'm creating a separate rule for 200, 225. Okay. I'm trying again. Wait.
Okay.
So LAN to WAN, the source from LAN zone, and I'm using from source address is 200.225. Destination, I'm trying to.
Can you please try /32?
/32.
Is it working?
Do you think it will work? /32.
It's for that particular IP, na?
It's a naming convention, right? It doesn't matter.
Wait. Can you use /32 on PC?
You cannot use, but for particularly denying access for system.
So how can you generate traffic if you use a object with /32? So how can you generate the traffic from this?
It will basically check that only that IP. If I think it's taking default /24, I guess.
Yes. I'm using right now /24. Okay, I'm using not default. See, if you want to create an object, you can create and you can specify the mask. See, here you can specify 200, 235, and here you can specify /28, 24. It's not by default. You can specify here. Okay. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, destination, van, and action. I'm going to allow log at session start. And see, when I create this rule, you can see, guys, our first rule is what? Allow this one. And now, land to van, this zone. And what in this rule, what I use? 200, 225, and I just allow 200, 225, and now you can see my first rule is what? Allow land to van, and here I just allow anyone from land to go van anywhere, and the traffic is, you can see, it's a deny. But in our second rule, what we have land to van, land user, and which land user I'm going to allow 200, 225 to go van zone, and traffic is what it's going to allow. Now I have a two rule. Remember access control list? Anyone? ACL?
Yeah, yes. Sir, but still out. It will not work. It will work from higher to lower. So first,
top to bottom approach
it will take. So it will not allow the particular.
Yes, repeats. Yes, that's the thing I'm going to show you. So we have a rule.
To move rule number 2 to there.
Wait. We need to verify first, na? We need to verify first. Is it working or not? Okay. Then so now we have a rule, deny rule first, and after that we have a allow rule. Now I'm going to commit. So I'm going to verify. The firewall box, Palo Alto box, will verify his first rule, then he will go to check his next rule, then and so on. So now I'm going to verify my internet connectivity. I'm going to close this one. I'm trying to open google.com. I cannot access. Why? Because he's exactly what he's trying. He's trying to check traffic is going to hit your Palo Alto device, and your Palo Alto device first rule is saying deny. Wait. Your first rule is saying from LAN user to van is called deny. Now it's not going to verify because I just define here anyone from LAN zone, any address. So it's going to first verify rule number 1, then he will go to rule number 2. In rule number 1, what he get? The user is coming from LAN zone. So I need to what? Deny. Understood, everyone? Clear? Some students are Rajnikant in this batch, but some students are new. So that's why I need to go with this. Clear? Now. So what I need to do? I need to allow 25. And I need to go click here in Palo Alto device. You can drag and drop the rule. You can select this rule and you can drag and drop. You can click here. And now your first rule is saying what? LAN users 200, 225 is going to hit, and he's just allow. Now I'm going to commit. So you can drag and drop the rule in Palo Alto device, like checkpoint and like 48, you can drag and drop the rule. Okay, everyone?
Clear? So basically, it means just a priority, right?
Wait. First verify. verify our traffic is working or not. Okay, then we will discuss the questions. So now I'm going to change IP address for this computer, and I'm going to define 200 225, and maybe it will work. Okay, and there is no need, otherwise I will restart this PC. So now 25, okay, close, and now see guys, perfect. 25 can access.
So practically it is perfect, but I just want to see it like theoretical, like in log, any hit is generating or not.
Obviously,
I promise I will tell you. Okay.
Sure.
But please go through with other students. Okay. There are some new students. Okay. I think you are working on with Palo Alto device, but right now I need to go step by step. Right.
Sure.
Okay. That is the reason. Some students are new. That's why I need to go with, step by step. See, so what exactly he can access internet, and you can verify it here. What is the IP address here? This PC IP address now is 200 200 225, and he can access internet. Now, see, what is exactly in our rule? We just allow 225. Okay, and just allow the traffic. Now I'm going to change again. See, I'm going to change again IP address. Okay. I'm going to use 15 again. Okay, close, and delete cache. Now you can verify here what is the IP address right now. Yes, the IP address is what? 200 215. So now in our rule we have what exactly we have? Our first rule is saying what? Any user from LAN, the user I'm going to allow 200 200 225, and the traffic is allow, right? But now another user is trying to access internet. Now this user is bought 200 200 215. So now for 200 215, there is a no matches for rule number one, then he will go for rule number two. Okay, rule number two. In rule number two, what you allow? LAN users. So now, and what exactly you just not allow, you just deny the traffic. Okay, so you can verify here again. I need to restart this device again. Wait, that is the problem, you know. Once the practical will work, once practical will not work. Yes, Abhishek, you can shift the rule. Okay, understood the rules, Abhishek. Okay, just like ACL, all the denied traffic you need to configure, first. After that, you can allow the traffic. Okay, you can define your allow traffic just like a access control list. Again, we are facing problem. Okay. But guys, understood the rule exactly? The rule is working fine. The concept is important, okay? We need to create a security policy. And now guys, let's take a break for 10 minutes, okay? And we will start at, it is 9:10, so we will start at 9:20. Please turn off your mic, okay? yes, Abhishek, I will discuss, you know, let's take a break for 10 minutes. Okay. Abhishek. Okay. Turn off your mic, everyone.